FIFA World Cup Qualifiers. 6 games, 5 wins, 1 draw, so we are already through. We are going to play against Romania. I'm going to change the team real quick. So guys, this is the team, of course. The first three squad is just our squad. Juhard, Stevens, Shaw, Henderson as CDM backup, Buckley as sentiment backup, Stirling and Sturridge on the bench, and on reserves, Butland, Klein, Smalling, Shelby and Workert. Of course, our formation. Captain is going to be Birch, why not? Free kicks should be... It's actually Ali is not... Ah, he is quite bad, okay. Then it is Luke Woods with the free kicks. All of them. Penalties, Armstrong, Luke Woods and Ali with the corners, why not? So now I'm going to build my second choice squad. Juhard, Klein of course, then Stevens and Smalling. Luke Shaw. Here I want to see Henderson. Where's Henderson? Here's Henderson. Sorry for that. I want to see Shelby and Buckley. Stirling, Workert, Sturridge. That's my second choice squad. So as you can see, my first choice squad is just dead. My second choice squad is also quite dead, but it's fine. So my second choice squad is playing against Romania. Birch is going to play. Because Henderson got a red card for some reason, and boom, it's a 2-1 win with Klein and Sturridge, Sterling scoring goals, and of course, it is just Sturridge getting injured. What else? 9 days. It is just Sturridge. It is what he's doing. He always is always getting injured. Sweden. Let's see if I can, if they actually have a good replacement of Ibrahimovic. Let's see who is the striker. It is not, no, it's Berg. Okay, that's not really good. Let's see, it's another 2-1 win. Berg actually scored, but Quay and Oxford scored for us. Yes, good wins. And now it's 100% sure we are going to get first place. Also in this training, a few players should go up. Yes, Woods going up to the 80, Wolford going up to the 71, Clements also going up to the 71 rating. So now I can stop training Luke Woods. I could, yeah, I was able to improve his stamina from 45 to 51. I mean, at least something. But I will give this slot to somebody else now. So a new month has started. We are in April. First of all, yeah, okay. We have a bad message. Training injury, it is for just 5 days from Birch. Okay, 5 days is fine. He is going to miss the game against Newcastle. Either way, so it's not really important. Scott monthly report, Morris is actually not that bad. He is a winger with some pace, 52 rated, high potential. Maybe I'm going to train him and try to get him to a good overall as quick as possible. Maybe I'm going to do that. Ben Chilwell gone up himself to the 76 rating. He is improving quite fast actually. He joined us 3 months, or around 2 months actually ago, and he is improving really fast. I like that. Matt Eldred going up again, the player we loaned out. I mean, he is still not going up quick enough, but he is improving everything but plus 3, 4 or 5. So he is still quite slow, bad stamina, not good in dribbling, not good in finishing. He can't do shit, to be fair. His only good abilities are free kicks, and that's not good enough, but he's at least improving really fast, plus 4 already in this season. Newcastle is actually a huge game, I'm going to play that one. But before that, we have a monthly score update. Charlie Birdsley is already 17, but his overall is 49 to 65, good potential, I'm going to sign it up. Butler is just shit. He is a goalkeeper, I don't need a goalkeeper, so he can just stay in here, but actually I'm just waiting, maybe if he is actually really high rated, but I don't need a goalkeeper, so there's no chance I'm going to sign him up. I just want to see if he is improving. Yeah, Birch injured and a red card, so that's not really interesting. Humphreys is going to play in this game. Other than this, I'm not changing anything. We are on some huge run. They are just one place behind us, 5 points. So if we win this game, it should be clear that we are at least in the top 6. In this season, or at least finishing in the top 6. Yeah, I don't have to change anything else. I mean, it's working. So as you guys know, I really, really like Newcastle. I played against them in the last season, in one of the last games, I think. Like, also in around, like, 7-8 games before the end. And we lost. And they played so freaking amazing. And I told you, they at that moment had actually a good chance, let's say like a 10 to 20% chance to win the league title, but the last games were just shit. I hope that that they would win the league title or Chelsea, because I quite like Chelsea as well. I mean, I just really like them because of Mourinho and a few players. So now I have nothing to do with Chelsea anymore. I'm not watching their games anymore. I always watch the games under Mourinho. Now I'm watching the games not anymore. So it is. It was just a Mourinho fan, to be fair. But I still like Chelsea a bit. But yeah, Chelsea, and if not Chelsea, then I wanted to Newcastle to win the league. Hope that somebody is here. Yeah, okay. Pass it to Luke Woods. Good first touch. Luke Woods is his left foot. Good save by Tim Krul. Oh, Iheanacho. We know Iheanacho from the Swansea career mode. He is a beast. Good save there. Henri, will cross it in. It's a good one. Oh, Compton with the header. He has actually quite good heading. I think like 75. But unfortunately, that was over the bar. Gray now. Trying to pass it through to Ali. Somehow worked out. Dele Alli, what a shot. Gets the rebound. I mean, he was unlucky, but also lucky. Unlucky that that perfect shot, of course, hit the post and not went in. But lucky that he got the rebound perfectly. I mean, he just assisted himself by that. Quite funny, actually. But Dele Alli scores again. I'm pretty sure he at least got 10 goals by now. Because he's actually scoring like every second game. He's in some really... I mean, he's just a beast. He's our highest rated player, and I see why. He is just a beast. Oh, nice long shot from the number 31. I don't know who it is, but that was a really nice long shot. Good save from Balanta. Last attack in the first half. Vignan done with a shot. Good save. They get the rebound, and they get the equalizer. And the last attack... it was a good save from Balanta. But, yeah, Sissoko, that was not necessary, that was stupid. Even though I have to say Newcastle is playing really good, so it war, or that equalizer is deserved, it's well deserved, they are playing really good. But with the last attack in the first half to concede, always a bad thing. Woof! Not Woff, Weff. Weff are we? He just headbutted, jumped into my player. It's a yellow, okay? It doesn't have to be a red card. But that was just brutal. That was just trying to kill my guy, to injure him, to break his legs. I mean, what the fuck was that? He has no chance to get the ball. We already have the ball, and then this. Compton. Oh, nice. Compton. Oh, nice. Oh, three players, four now. Short post, please. Oh, cool with the save. Reeves. Woods. No, I will not go too attacking. Even though it wouldn't be really attacking to bring on Reeves, to be fair. But I will bring on Ryan Woods, who is running a lot and who is quite good in attacking, crossing, passing as well. One more, I thought it's actually a perfect cross. So I think... that's the right decision. Quay is off. And Wilford is on. And Sutton, of course, Sutton is playing on the left side. Wilford on the right side. Some new fresh legs. Some pace up front. Oh, no, guys. Oh, don't give a penalty. Always when something like this happens, you will have to be afraid that the ref is just giving a penalty. Yeah. I think I have to go defensive, even though it is just a draw and I really wanted to win the game. But right now, I would be quite lucky with that point. So I will go a bit safer. 3 minutes extra time. Another shot. Balanta, what the fuck? That was so fucking close. Probably even touched the fucking... nice, the fucking post. Come on. Armstrong up front. Why is not Wilford up front? Yeah, it's game over. I mean, I'm happy. Away against Newcastle. Look at that statistics, that match facts. They dominated the game 100%. It is a lucky draw and I will take the point. So guys, now Balanta is asking for higher wages. Which is fine because he still probably just earns like a few thousand. Yeah, 4,000 pounds. He's asking for 5. That's just nothing, but yeah, 1 year Kush, we are going to add 1 year. Kush is first team player. I mean, next year is the last year. We are 6th place, so still not in the top 4, but I mean, it is. Look at the table, we have 58. Spurs, Arsenal and City have 59 and Everton has 60. Chelsea again 9 points clear, so I think they are going to win the title. So guys, as you guys know, I wanted to improve everybody in our first try squad to a 60. To an 80, not a 60, 80, or comp to a 65, that's what I wanted to say, because it is around at 70, 16, 17 difference, so I think he is already 80 if he would be a wide winger, but I don't care. To a 65 and every first choice player to an 80, we did that now. So now I will go for every backup to a 75. Clement should go up to a 75 real quick. I'm training Wolford and comp until 65, then I'm going to train my other backups, because next season I want to go into my last season with a full 80 first choice squad and a full 75 rated backup. That is my goal, because then we definitely have a team which could be strong enough to actually win the Champions League. So Ballanta accepted the contract offer. We got a game against West Ham. I'm just going to play one of these two games in this month. West Ham or Man City. And then I think it's quite clear that I'm not playing against West Ham, who are actually 12th place, 41 points. So, first choice squad, first choice squad, everybody's fit. I know it's an away game against West Ham, but it should be a win, come on, we cannot, please don't drop points, they are on a good run, but it is West Ham, it's just West Ham. I know we lost against Watford as well, but come on, it's just West Ham, we need 3 points. Antonio of course scored for them, Ballanta is getting injured, what the fuck? Why are we, every time I'm simulating we are losing, it does make sense for me, because we have an amazing squad. Why are we losing every fucking game? Woods for Woods? We are losing. Guys, I don't get it. I knew we are going to lose, that's why I told you that. Because I would be a bit surprised. I mean, that is so bad for us. But I just simulated the games against Watford and against West Ham and we are losing. That's why I cannot play every game. But because, therefore I have to simulate a few games and we are losing all these games. We have problems to qualify for Champions League, and we are going to have huge problems in the next season if we want really to win the title. Because we have the team who can do that, but I have to simulate a few games and every time I do that, yeah. Compton is 64, so I want to improve his overall now just one more time. Ballanta is out for 2 months. Basically, he may play in the last few games again, but that's it. So now I have to play with Clements, who is going up to the 72. So, I mean, he is not that shit, but that's just a bad news. Good news is that we are playing at home, and we still didn't lose any game at home. 17. just think about it. Just think about it. Let's say you are 17 years old, a backup of maybe the best English goalkeeper, and you have time to improve, have to try time to learn from him, and then he's getting injured straight before one of the most important games at home against fucking Man City, and now with your 17 years you have to play that game. That is so much pressure. I hope he can take it. Oh my god. Oh no, that's not, guys, please. Guys, please. I mean, okay. Look at that. Just look at it. Henri, I don't know. But Clement's not doing anything. Then this guy. Then not shooting out. I'm pressing the button. He's doing that. Clement's jumping, not taking the ball. Goal. I'm thinking about cheating. I'm thinking about just giving me a goal now, because that is not what I wanted to see. I will not do it yet. But in case we are losing this game 1-0, in case we are losing this game 1-0, I'm going to play this game again. Or go, if you lose, or play 1-1 or whatever. If this goal is really important, if we are losing 3-0, it's not. But if it's really important, I'm going to replay this game. Alright, because that is not how I want to drop 2 or 3 points, that's not, I mean, again, EA, told us they improved the goalkeepers. They are intelligent now. Yeah, I see that. So guys, here you can see we lost 2-1. And I told you I cannot do it like this. So I'm going to restart the game. I'm going to play it again. The second goal actually was completely bullshit as well. I mean, it was almost the same thing. And I told you, I'm going to play the game again. So guys, you may ask why I'm not just now talking, yo, let's play the game, let's see what Clemens can do. Like, I haven't played against them yet, because I'm quite honest. I'm an honest person, that's the second time I'm playing against them. I wanted to show you that I'm restarting the game and why I'm restarting the game. It's the first time in AFVK Yimod I restarted a game. Except once, because my recording software bugged there. It was a game, I think, also in this game mode against Arsenal. And my recording, it was like 30 minutes in. I think we were actually losing, but it wasn't the reason my recording software was had a problem. And so I stopped the game, and I recognized it was just this game. Other than this, everything was fine. So I just replayed this game. So yeah, but that wasn't cheating. This time, I mean, we really just dropped 3 points because of this goal, and that is not fair in my opinion. I mean, I know that there are many bullshit goals, but that is not enough. That is too much. That is just too much. And it's my career mode, and I don't like to do this in my career modes, but in some career modes, if something really, really bullshit happens, if something really bad happens in a really important game, and this is, if you lose the game, the thing is, we would have lost the game, and that would have been it. We would not play Champions League next season, 95%, almost a goal for them. And that only because of that goal, because of that thing, and that's what why I said no. So that's why I decided to repeat the game. So you know, that's my second time I play this this game, and you know why. Alright, I think that's just fair. If I would watch me or myself, then I would like to hear that, to know that. So that's why I tell you that. But yeah, let's hopefully win the game this time. Okay, oh, it's not a goal. I thought it's a goal, and I just want to say, of course, this guy is smashing it in with a fucking bicycle kick. Last game, actually, Man City dominated us for the first, like, let's say 40 minutes. They scored this fucking goal, had many chances, Clemens made many amazing oh my god, Compton hasn't scored for so long. Really, for at least, like, I mean, this could actually be his first goal in this season. I actually don't know if he ever scored in the season before, and then he scored this goal in this game. No, he scored 7 somehow. But then when I simulate it, I'm quite sure, because I don't know if I ever scored a goal with him in this episode, in this season yet. He could score another one. Yeah, and I'm strong! Of course, perfect save, hit the post. What else, man? Halftime, we are winning at the moment. 45 minutes to go. The bad thing is, I think the last time we actually kept a clean sheet is like 5-6 episodes ago. The last 2-3 episodes, we definitely never kept a clean sheet. So, I'm quite sure that City is going to score a goal. We are not keeping a clean sheet. Basically, straight away, yep, they score a goal. Told you. And that basically means we have to score at least one more. Just when I tell you, it's so good. We didn't concede, but come on, we cannot keep a clean sheet. I'm quite sure we're going to concede straight away. We concede a goal. Quay is getting in his way, so we'll just take the ball, Quay. Good save from Joe Hart. Please. What a mistake, Quay. Pass it back. What is that? What is that, guys? We are taking the ball. We are 3-1. Armstrong is dropping back perfectly. I'm pressing the X button. Just a normal pass back. And that is why, that is the FIFA bullshit I talk about after the update. Because FIFA is not doesn't want to score. I just press the X button and just tap it and then this. What is the point of that? What is the point of that, guys? Wolfhood Sutton is on and also Luke Woods is on, Ryan Woods. Here's Wolfhood. Has some space, ball wall. Has that pace, is going through. It is not a nice angle, but yeah. 2 minutes extra time. Wolfhood still hasn't scored. Now it would be the perfect moment for him to score his first goal. Ali, of course. Of course, the guy is doing the perfect thing, so it's a foul. I think it's going to be a draw, which is still fine. I mean, we still didn't lose at home. 15 games. 11 wins and then 4 draws. But it was a huge chance for us. I mean, it's fine. I take the draw. I take it. Everton is the next game. We are May. Yeah, let's end the episode with a Youthhood report. Birdsley is going down. And this guy is also going down. Oh, really? Nobody again. So guys, if you enjoyed the episode, please smash the like button. Next episode could be the final. Everton is third place. We have to win. If we not win against Everton, it basically, I think we won't win. We won't get fourth place. At least we would need to be really lucky that the other guys are dropping many points. If you enjoyed the episode, as I just told you, please smash the like button. I will see you tomorrow. I'm quite tired now. I recorded more than almost 2.5 hours. I'm a bit dead. Therefore, I'm stopping recording now. Have an amazing day, guys. Oh, Armstrong, 22 goals. Bye.